Hope everyone is having a great day today on what would have been and what still is in a backyard version of our 14th year of North Liberty Blues and Barbecue. I am Jillian Miller, one of the chairs of the event, and we are doing interviews with committee members today for a behind-the-scenes look at what goes into making the festival happen. I am joined now by Jean Keeley. She is our volunteer guru, and if you have volunteered for the event before, you've seen her in your inbox and day of the event. Welcome, Jean.
Hi, glad to be here.
Thank you. We just want to dive right into what it takes to pull off volunteers at Blues and Barbecue. So how many volunteers does it take?
Up 400. This year.
400.
And that's including our committee members. But it's grown from the first year that I first was coordinating volunteers, would have been 2013. And we had 126 volunteers that year.
And that's mainly just that day. I mean, there's a few people in the days around it.
That's including a few people that help the day before, or maybe the week before. And our wonderful cleanup crew the next day. It's everybody.
You know, when did you get involved with Blues? You were always involved when I joined the committee. So when did it all start for you?
Well, the first Blues and Barbecue Festival was held in 2007 at Liberty Center. It was a Sunday afternoon, and I remember just going to it and having some food and listening to some music. It was a pretty small gig comparative to now. And then over the next several years, I know I volunteered 3 times. Doing a variety of different things, and was invited to join the committee starting in 2013 to help with volunteers. So I've been involved almost every year, just coming out to have a good time and listen to live music, or as a volunteer myself, and then as the volunteer coordinator.
Awesome. Well, we know you do so much for the festival and appreciate it so much. Managing up to 400 volunteers, like you just mentioned, is such a task. So how do you keep everything organized?
Well, it's important to me that anybody who's ever volunteered in the past is kept in the loop, because we know not everybody can volunteer maybe every single year, depending on the date and what they have going on. So we keep a master list of anybody that's ever volunteered in the past. So when we send out initial communications about when the festival is coming up and things, anybody that's on that Blues volunteer team is going to be in the loop. And granted, anybody can opt out at any time if they move away or whatever. But if you don't volunteer 1 year, if you're not able to, you're not forgotten, you know. Mm-hmm. We will keep you in the loop as long as you want to be kept in the loop. And so I manage that list on MailChimp. That's kind of our main database there, is where we keep everybody. And that list is about 650 or 60 people right now.
Awesome.
Yeah. And I do want to add, if anybody wants to be in the loop of volunteering, we definitely can add you now for next year, so that you know, we can just add you in on the Blues volunteer list, so that when we start planning for next year, you can get in on the advance news.
Yeah, and let us know just by messaging us on our Facebook page or emailing info@northlibertyblues.org, and we'll make sure to get you connected with Jean and on that list.
Yeah, and then the actual slots are like all of our, what positions are there, how many people do we need for each time, all the shift times and everything. We use a really great service called Volunteer Local. And I've been really happy with it. I think all of our volunteers have been really happy with it in terms of it's easy to use and user-friendly.
So you started talking about it a little bit, just talking about your organization method, but can you share with us what your process is working through the volunteer program? When do you start in the year? How do you recruit? How often you communicate, and what that looks like day of the event and after the event?
Sure. We actually start recruiting volunteers pretty much the day after the festival ends, because I always send out, we're very grateful for our volunteers. We think we have the best volunteer team that there is. And we always say we love our volunteers, and Blues volunteers are the best. And those are not just taglines. I think that is really true. Mm-hmm. And so right after the festival is over, within 24 hours, usually, I like to send out a very heartfelt thank you to everybody that actually volunteered that year. And I like to include, you know, we always get a lot of great feedback from the festival goers, a lot of times citing, you know, how the volunteers were so polite and friendly and things like that. And so I like to give our Blues volunteers that feedback right away.
Yeah.
And I always include save the date for next year. And so people can get it on their calendars right away if they want to. And then after that, that initial, you know, here's the date for next year. That's a whole year away. Mm-hmm. It's usually sometime in March, maybe early to mid-March, when they're going to hear from us again, you know, as far as reminding of the date that's coming up and getting them, you know, getting them ready to know, hey, we're going to have all the positions open here on such and such a date, so watch your inbox. And after that, about every 2 weeks through the spring and through June, and then when it gets closer to the festival date, those who are actually signed up to volunteer, we will send more detailed information, you know, the week prior, like, mm-hmm. Here's a map of the festival grounds. Here's where you can park. Here's where the volunteer tent is for you to check in. If you want to pick up your shirt early, like the day before, this is when we're going to be doing that. You know, we try to give everybody as much information about the festival as possible, and not only for their role that they're going to play on the day of, but also we want to make sure our volunteer, you know, we keep the shifts pretty short. Most of the shifts are just 2 hours, maybe three at the very most. And we want our volunteers to be able to stay and encourage them to stay and bring their friends and family back or whatever and enjoy the festival for themselves too. So mm-hmm. we want to make sure they're informed about everything that's going to be going on throughout the day, not just related to their role, you know, yeah. so that they're very as informed as we can make them. Coming into the day. So
what are some of those roles that you're talking about? What's the variety of roles that people could expect volunteering for Blues and how much it changes maybe year to year or as the festival has grown?
Really the roles just, they run the gamut from, you know, lots of working with kids. We have those who take care of kind of the grounds and the eco team. Mm-hmm. We've got a lot of greeters at the front entrances and parking lots and things like that, shuttle stops to help direct people and just welcome people to the park and to the festival. We have what I kind of call volunteer care, and that's those volunteers who are helping to care for other volunteers, like driving around the festival grounds and delivering water. Working in the volunteer tent and helping to answer questions. As I mentioned earlier, we have our setup and our teardown crews and the days leading up to the festival and the day after. We have obviously a lot of beverage garden roles, probably 5 or 6 different roles right there just in the beverage right. garden. We've got some stage related roles. And I'm sure there's some I'm forgetting. So there's quite a few.
Well, and there really is something for everyone, whether you're someone that needs to have more of a seated position or you're able to do some heavy lifting. Yeah. All ages can get involved as well when you have, you know, if there's someone younger, maybe volunteer with a parent. I know yeah. we've even done some things over the years where we have recruited some groups, you know, to volunteer together and maybe earn some money for the organization too. So your love for Blues and Barbecue is so apparent. What is it about the event that makes it so special to you?
Just walking through and seeing all ages having a good time and knowing that we're able to provide this for free is just gives me a lot of joy on that day.
Yeah, I definitely share those feelings. Making me miss it a lot right now describing it.
Yes, me too.
Thank you for chatting with us a little bit about volunteers and the volunteer program for Blues and Barbecue. We're ending each committee interview today asking what track they might want to hear next on our station. So what do you want to hear, Jean?
This is hard, but I think I'm going to have to go with All I Ever Wonder by St. Paul and the Broken Bones.
Oh, that's a good one. Okay. Well, let's hear it, everyone.